Okay, so for this next simulation, we're going to get a little bit more ambitious and we're going to simulate the random drawing of a card from a deck of cards. To model this on Excel, we're going to need to use an additional couple of functions to the ones that we've met already. We will be using the VLOOKUP function, and we'll also be using wildcards within our COUNTIFS. So a few new things to for the kids to get their heads around. Although according to the DCF, it is they are functions that they would expect pupils in Key Stage 3 to be able to use comfortably. So here we go. We'll start off in the usual way. We will simulate 10 draws first of all, just to make sure everything is working as we would expect it to be, and then we will extend it to 1,000. So first of all, we will get our count going. So draw 1, 2, 3 down to 10. Let's center these columns. And then we need to generate a random number to link to our deck of playing cards. And there are 52 cards in a deck, so we are going to need to generate a number, a random number, so rand between 1 and 52. So we'll fill that down as well. So you can see all those numbers there are between 1 and 52. And what we now need to do is to make sure each of these random numbers is linked to a unique card in the deck. So I now need to create a deck of cards, and I'm going to do this on a different tab. So I'm going to go down and hit the New Sheet button there, and this is where I'm going to create my deck of cards. So the first column is going to be a list of those numbers between 1 and 52 that are generated or could be generated by the random number function. Again, let's centralize these columns. And then for each of these, I'm going to associate a card value. So ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king. And that's replicated for each suit. So I'm going to copy that and paste it another 3 times, which should take us down to 52. And then the suits. So if the first suit is C for clubs, I'm going to fill that down the king. Then the other black one is spades, diamonds, and hearts. So to get a unique card, what I now need to do is to join these two cells together. So the way we do that is using the and symbol, so equals that cell and that cell, so creating the ace of clubs. Fill that down. So we see there what we're doing here is that we are matching the random number. So if the random number generated is a 6, then we'll return that that's the card, the 6 of clubs. If the random number generator is generated as a 24, it'll return the jack of spades. So what we now need to do is to tell Excel that this is where our deck of cards is, and it links the card with this random number. So what I've done now is, or what I'm going to do now, is I'm going to highlight this whole table and I'm going to call it deck. Okay, that's my deck of cards. That's where I'm going to go looking to see, to match my random number to the card that it represents. Right, so that's done. I go back to sheet one now and get my column going for card. Got my caps lock stuck on. So what I want to do is find out in put in this cell the card from the deck that is identified by the number 23, and here the number 21, and so on. And in order to do that, we're going to use the VLOOKUP function, and I'll explain when, as we build it, how that works. So in that cell there, C2, we're going to type equals, and then we're going to start typing the word VLOOKUP. Once it appears in blue, if you double click it, it will appear in the formula cell. Now you could type, if you know what you're doing, you could type the rest of the expression up there. But in order to explain it, it's easier if you press the FX button to get the function box up like that. And then we can see what each argument is that we need to put in. So the first thing it wants to know is, what is it looking for? What value is it looking for? Well, it's looking for the value that is in cell B2, which was the number 23. And you can see there, it's looking for the number 23. It then wants to know, well, where is it looking for it? So it's going to look for it in the deck, or the sheet that we produced and defined as deck. So when you type deck in there, you can see it's immediately recognized. Number one is the ace of clubs. Number two is the two of clubs, and so on. So we know that that's right. And what the way that this works is, it looks in the first column of deck for the number 23. And when it finds it, it will put in this cell the value that's in the corresponding column that you want. Now, we were in the actual card was in the fourth column. So you can see there, that's going to return the 10 of spades. And then in this final column, we're just going to type false. Now, all that does is it tells it that it's not looking for an approximate outcome, it's looking for an exact outcome. So the first number, the first argument is, what's it looking for, which is the contents of B2. It's looking for it in the first column of deck, and when it finds it, it will return the value that's in the fourth column of deck. So every time we change something in Excel, it recalculates the value. So as you can see there, it's no longer the number 23 that appears there. So the number 12 relates to the Queen of Clubs. If we now drag that down and fill down, you can see how this is working. So we're generating random numbers between 1 and 52, and then the VLOOKUP function is going to the deck of cards we created and finding out what card relates to the number 44, which is the 5 of hearts. Jack of diamonds comes up consecutively, and so on and so on. So that's how we're generating those cards. So that seems to work. So let's now extend to a deck of 1,000. An experiment with 1,000 draws. So to there, and then we're going to fill these two columns down, so down as far as there. So I'm holding shift down to highlight those two columns, and then I'm going to fill down. So fill down, there you go, we got 1,000 draws of the card. When we are tallying these up now, I need to define this range of cards. So I will call that draw, and that defines where I'm going to be tallying. Right, so let's say that we want to see the distribution of suits that are coming out of those 1,000 draws. So it should come out, there's four suits, they're all equally likely, so we should be looking for each of those coming out about 250 times out of 1,000. But let's now produce a group frequency diagram to test that. So the suits, hearts, diamonds, clubs, and spades. And we can do a count if, but this time, and what's great with the way that we've coded this pack of cards is the suits and the values are have all got unique parts to them. The suit H is only hearts, D is only diamonds, C clubs, and S spades, for example. So what I'm looking for here is to count how many cards in that 1,000 contain the letter H. Doesn't matter what's connected to it, it's just the letter H, and that's where the wild card comes in. So this is how we're going to code this. Count if draw, because we've defined that, and then equals, and the H is the final value in each cell, so I don't care what happens before it, so I'm going to put the star in there. The star is the wild card, which means anything that ends in a H. So if I close the inverted commas and close the brackets, so count if anything in there contains or ends in the letter H. I was expecting about 250, I got 245, I'm quite happy with that. So for the next one, it'll be equals count if the draw, comma, open brackets, equals, this time, star, capital D, close bracket, close inverted commas, close bracket. Around the 250 again, equals count if the draw contains anything ending in a C. And finally, equals count if the draw contains anything ending in an S. So there you go. Let's centralize that and let's produce a pie chart with that information in it. So I've highlighted the figures, insert pie. I need to relate the slices to the suit, so I've clicked in there, I've right clicked, select data, axis labels, edit, pull those in. So there you can see the blue is the hearts, and then if you right click again and add data labels and callouts, it's showing you there's a percentage of the suits that are being generated. If we add our little button, so developer, insert button, and redraw, new, calculate, name, give the button a name, redraw, then that will draw another 1,000 cards from your deck. And again, you can see there what you'd expect, which is that the suits are coming out about a quarter of the time, each suit. Okay, well, let's see what happens if we check how frequently each value card is being drawn. So we'll set up another frequency table. So value of the card and the frequency. So the value of the card is going to go ace, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, jack, queen, king. Center those. And again, it's a count if. It's on that same defined column, draw. But this time, we're interested in the unique value of the first part of the cell, the Q, the 4, the 7, the J. And even with the 10 of hearts, which is the only one which is three characters, that one is unique because the value one is actually the ace. So this time when I'm count-ifing, draw, this time it is the first term I'm interested in, and anything else that comes after it doesn't matter. Now, if I only put the equals A in there, it would be looking for a cell that only contains an A. So by putting the asterisk after it means that so long as the first term is an A, the first part is an A, everything else doesn't matter. And then close the bracket. So that occurs 83 times. Now this time what I'm going to do, rather than have to retype that every time, I'm going to fill that down. And then I'm going to go in and edit each one. So that's going to be a 2-star. Then I'm going to have 3-star, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. For 10, I'm just interested in 1. And then jack, queen, and king. Right, this will be a bit crowded as a pie chart. But so it's probably more appropriate with this one if we produce a bar chart for this one. So if we highlight that column and insert bar, and then what we want to do is to change these x-axis labels. So select data, horizontal labels, and drag them down. Gone far enough there, yes. So you can see there we've got the ace to the king. And if we redraw again, you can see that they may look quite volatile, because again, what's happening, if you look at the vertical axis, it's on automatic. But if we actually change that to go from 0 to 1,000 for 1,000 draws, then when we redraw, we'll see that they aren't that volatile really. They're all coming up a pretty similar amount. Okay. So that is simulating drawing from a pack of playing cards.